Hello everyone. This is George Doucettis. I'm coming from Heriot Watt University, where, unlike some of the previous presentations, we're a reasonably new group. I'll put in the first slide here some photos for introductions. We're about 9 faculty at the moment. Four years ago, you would find 3. The last year, we recruited another 3. So it's myself and I'm full-time with the university since 2014. We're about 30-40 odd research staff with PhD students. And the areas that we are looking on is high-frequency electronics and antennas. So a lot of the electronics that will be used for the link from the space to the ground. So I've structured, I've got 3 slides really after that. I tried to keep that short. I've structured it around sort of the work we do for the space segment, some example projects. We work on antennas, and we have a couple of projects with on designing technologies for multi-beam reflector antennas for high throughput platforms. We have in-house physical optics. We use also external software for that. So we have a couple of ESA projects on this. At the bottom here, there is some CubeSat work that a colleague from Canada did on behalf of the Canadian Space Agency. Actually designed this UHF antenna module here for communication to the ground. We're also looking into passive components and their high power performance. This is from a recently concluded ESA activity on multi-factor and miniature filters. We're looking in, we have a specific expertise in filters, micro filters for both planar and cavities, looking in aspects like thermal compensation, planar technologies, all the way from sort of design to analysis to mechanical drawings and implementation. Some work for the ground segment and some projects around satellite on the moon. We have a large European Commission project around QV band technology for terminals, which is quite considered now for sort of gateway feeds. We're also looking into technologies for satellite on the move, and at the moment we have a project on Ka band 30 gigahertz power amplifiers. We're trying to develop technology there. We're also doing the whole chain from L band all the way to Ka band. Again, we have the full in-house capability in terms of the designing of the RF subsystem and the analysis and the integration. More recently, we worked on an ESA activity shown here that has to do with the flat dish on how you can basically generate a directed beam good enough to connect you to space, but without using a dish, and will be suitable for mobile platforms, so you can beam steer basically. So this is a TRP ongoing activity with ESA. We also have interest on modeling the entire link. We do analog signal analysis, nonlinear signal analysis, and we also do digital signal analysis, modeling the digital channel. Modeling various imperfections in terms of the nonlinearities, noise, and the propagation channel. The initiative we are pursuing at the moment, and that's why I put here a slide on the side, is to set up in Heriot Watt in Edinburgh a receive terminal for the AlphaSat Q-band propagation experiment. So this is an experimental payload on board AlphaSat with a 40 gigahertz beacon, and we're looking to work with NASA to set up a terminal to receive the signal and do propagation analysis and introduce that in our signal, in our link sort of estimations. So I don't have any more slides, that's me. As I said, we've been working quite closely with the European Space Agency and European Commission and space is sort of the RF electronics space remains one of our interests, and we're open to working with people in Scotland for that. Thank you.